Psychologically, women are not in a state of mind where going to the police is even possible many times. And also women have reported that they have also been assaulted by police, by the very people who are supposed to be protecting them and their legal right to not be violated.
Mental health is such a Western concept, and then how do you relate that to other areas where that isn't maybe the dialogue that you have? And I've seen projects get really creative where there's music. A few projects in South Sudan and some other places, we will have what we call the mental health band or something similar. And it's a group of people who often have some also mental health training, but they're musicians and they go and play once a day in the hospital or a couple times a week in the community, and people come and have relief of, you know, these horrible feelings that they might be having. But it's the music of the culture and the community. And
if we know that we cannot continue with the patient, this is very technical, but we focus our intervention in a single consultation, we call it. So we are sure that we are going to support the person in what is happening today to this person. So we don't open, let's say, things that we cannot continue working on.
It has to do with power. Sexual violence is a matter of power, and women are second-class citizens throughout the world. And as long as that continues, there will be intimidation and fear, humiliation through sexual violence.
Training is a big part of our activities, always. So we never work alone. We work with 10 times more people than locals, than national staff, and we constantly training them. So we train them in counseling techniques, how to talk to a victim. We train them in how to approach the communities, how to solve the problems. So we do that in normal daily basis in all our projects.